The Bible says in Ezekiel chapter 33, from 14 to 16. Again, when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, if he turns from his sin and do that which is lawful and right, if the wicked restore the pledge and give again that he has robbed, walk in the statutes of life without committing iniquity, he shall surely live, he shall not die. None of his sins which he has committed shall be mentioned unto him again. He has done that which is lawful and right, he shall live. Leviticus chapter 6 from 2 to 5 says, if a soul sin and commit a trespass against the Lord, or lie to his neighbor in that was delivered him to keep, or in fellowship in that was taken away by violence, or deceive his neighbor, or has found a thing that was lost, and lieth concerning it, and sweareth falsely. In any of these that a man doeth, sinning therein, then it shall be that because he hath sinned and is guilty, that he shall restore that was delivered him to keep, or the lost thing which he hath found, or any of those things for which he hath sworn falsely, that he shall restore it even in the principal, and shall add the fifth part thereto, and give it to him unto whom it appertaineth in the day of his trespass offering. Matthew chapter 5 from 23 to 24 says, if thou bring thy gift to the altar, and there rememberest that thy brother hath aught against thee, leave there thy gift before the altar, go first, be reconciled to thy brother, then come and offer thy gift. Luke 19 and verse 8. And Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord, behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold. And Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation come to this house. In Acts 24, verse 16, the Apostle Paul writes, and herein do I exercise myself, to have always a conscience void of offense toward God and toward men. And in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, he continues, If any man is in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Mark the words, therefore, behold, and the sentence, old things are passed away. Therefore, telling us that man is coming from somewhere, to Jesus, from his adultery, from his fornication, his uncleanness, his wickedness, his evil, his lies. Behold, calling our attention to see that from the time this man came into Christ, he does not commit adultery any longer. He does not commit fornication any longer. He steals no more, covets no more. He has made up his mind to abandon his wickedness, all his evil, his uncleanness, no more lying on his lips. He has been washed in the blood, broken and recreated by the word of God. And the word keeps him from falling. Old things are passed away. All things have become new. Meaning that when a sinner gets converted, all his sins are forgiven him, while at the same time his conscience is being made alive again to make him to see how wrong his thoughts and actions were, to push him to make amends to the men and women he has wronged, and to keep him from committing those past sins again. A clear conscience is listed in scripture as one of the essential weapons for a successful spiritual life and ministry. A good conscience involves an inner freedom of spirit, which comes when we know that God is not offended with our thoughts and actions. When a good conscience is corrupted, my brother, one's faith, prayer life, communion with God, and life of good deeds, these are seriously damaged. If you reject a good conscience, it will result in the shipwreck of your faith. If you do, even Judas Iscariot will condemn you on the last day, because it will appear that his conscience would have been more sensitive than yours. For when his conscience smote him, he returned the 30 pieces of silver to the men, although he failed to repent. Here is the need for restitution. My brother, restitution means the restoration of stolen or misappropriated things, property or person to their rightful owner, paying one's debt, uncovering crimes committed, giving back where one has defrauded, confessing lies told, making concessions to people that are offended, and apologizing to those that are slandered. My brother, you don't need to allow the devil to hinder you. Shame and fear are the wicked devices the devil uses against new converts and even those who have believed for making heaven. No, bro, you don't have to cry. Whatever it is, let me hear it, and I'll counsel you. Let me hear you.
Please, pray for me. Pray for me that I may be able to carry this cross. My sins are too much. I don't know where to begin.
My brother, I like the way you feel. You see, God's word says that godly sorrow worketh repentance. You see, you need to open up no matter what. God's word says in Proverbs 28:13 that whoso covereth his sin shall not prosper, but whosoever confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. Open up. Do sit down. Sit down. Feel free. Pour out your heart to God. He will hear you. Whatever it is, feel free. Say it.
How are you?
Hi, Ogabo, you're welcome, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, okay. Often busy.
Welcome, brother.
How are you?
All right. Okay, I finished the job. It's perfect, sir. It's perfect, sir. This is your khaki, sir.
Okay.
And you can see where I pass it. Okay, sir.
Okay. Wow. Wow, boom. This man did the perfect work. Kai!
I have no doubt in my mind she will always do a very clean and decent job.
But Bob, you know I'm worried.
Worried? Why?
Are you sure you're going to use this chip? Have you considered the risk? The engine and chassis number? What are you going to do about them?
Come. Let me show you something.
Hang on there. Let me open it and show you exactly what I mean.
Oh, this is the engine number. You can see. And over here, you have the chassis number. So you can go through the paper and tell me what you have seen. Interesting. Exactly the way it is.
My God. Bob! How did you do it? Did you change the whole of the engine and chassis?
We are very close, Paul. But I must keep this from you. This is why I want to be in the auto business.
Come on, hop in, let's go. What about the bees?
The bill? I paid it.
Come on, let's go.
There's a line that is drawn by rejecting our Lord, where the call of the Spirit is lost. And you hurry along with the pleasure made strong. Have you counted? Have you counted the cost?
Have you counted the cost? If your soul should be lost, will you gain the whole world for your own?
Ooh, yeah.
Even now it may be, but the line you have crossed.
Have you counted?
Have you counted?
Counted the cost. You may bet your hope of eternity's more, for a moment of joy at the most, for the glitter of sin and the things it will win. Have you counted? Have you counted the cost?
Have you counted the cost? If your soul should be lost,
though you gain
the whole world for your own, even now it may be, but the line you
have crossed.
Have you counted?
Have you counted
the cost?
While the door of His mercy is open to you, at the depth of His love you exhaust, won't you come and
be healed? I would like you to have this.
Won't you whisper and yield? I have counted. I have counted.
You don't want me to insult you. Just get out of my face.
Have you counted the cost? If your soul should be lost, you gain the whole world for your own.
What did I tell you about these people? Paul, I understand. But just because they were very cautious in the way and manner with which they approached me, I couldn't just send them away.
Look, if we must be in this partnership, the rules and conditions must be obeyed. Two can never work together except they agree, Paul.
Paul, I understand. Trust me, I do. Sit down and have some. Sit down.